And in Aqeedah, we follow the Aqeedah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but as presented to us, explained to us by Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari and Imam Abu Mansur al-Maturidi, both of them came in a dark time where Ahl al-Sunnah were oppressed and they advocated the doctrine of Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. I would say, for example, in the sub-Indian continent, if you love Imam Ahmad Ridha Khan, you're from Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. I would say, for example, in the Middle East and North Africa, if you love Al-Shaykh Yusuf al-Nabhani, you are from Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. If you're against Al-Imam Al-Shaykh Yusuf al-Nabhani, you're against Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. You're familiar with Al-Imam Al-Shaykh Yusuf al-Nabhani, the best lover of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Middle East, who authored dozens of books in praise of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in prayers on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in description of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and on and on and on. So these people can distinguish.
Of course.
By following them, we know who we are, and by attacking them or criticizing them, we know who the other party is.
Of course.
That is probably in a nutshell defined for our modern viewers. If we go back in history, for example, anyone who criticizes Imam Ghazali, put a question mark in front of him, he doesn't belong to Ahlus Sunnah.
Any scholarly personality from the Indo-Pak subcontinent that you personally have been inspired by, or you studied, or you...
Well, definitely, the Muslim Ummah is one body. And scholars from the East and the West of Ahlus Sunnah belong to one tree.
Subhanallah.
Now, it has many branches, but we are connected to each other exactly like tissues belonging to one body.